Welcome back, everyone, to 10 Minutes with Ms. Campos. I am glad that you are joining me once again. In today's lesson, we will learn about making connections. This skill is very important in our everyday lives. We make connections all the time. We relate to people, situations, events, or anything that might impact us. It is within our nature to relate to our surroundings. I will teach you three ways to connect to text and how does it help us deepen our understanding. Let's categorize those connections so that it helps us become better readers and writers.
Out of all these comprehension strategies that we are learning, we will focus in making connections.
In our day two lesson, we learned how to infer, which means to make an inference. We make an inference using text evidence and background knowledge. Our background knowledge consist of our personal experiences. When we use our personal experience, we are making connections with the text. And there are three types of connections that we can do with the text. We can use the text to make connections to ourselves. We can make connections with another text that we have read. And we can use the text to make connections to the world. Let's take a look at each of these three closely. Using the text to make connections to yourself is more general. You can compare the story or the texts to something that you remember that you probably liked or disliked. For example, the character could be eating a meal in the story and you remember a time you ate that same meal and didn't like it. When you're making text-to-text connections, you have to extend your thinking a little bit more on the stories you have read, a book, or something that you have read that is the same or similar to this text, what made both of the texts different, and what scene changed, what character changed. So you're comparing two texts together and looking at similarities and differences. In text-to-world connections, a bit more complex, because you have to think a little bit more outside of the book, outside of yourself. Think about an event that happened around your city or in your town that is similar to what's happening in the text or in the book. This could be something that's happening in the news or something that's happening in your country or another country. Try to relate the book to what's happening around you. So we start with text to self, which is very general and simple. Compare the story to you, compare the story to another story that you have read, and then compare the story to what's happening around the world. When I talk about the text, I'm talking about anything that has a written language, a book, a newspaper, a passage, a story, anything that you can read. So for example, I can take a song and call it the text because it has lyrics. So I can connect a song to myself and relate to the song and try to connect how the song relates to me. I can take the same song and compare it to another song. How is this song similar to another song? Perhaps in the rhythm, in the music, the lyrics, or even the artist. And then I can take the song and connect it to what's happening around the world. Think about the message. What is the message of the text, the song? How can I connect it with what's happening around the world? Maybe the song is about wanting to be a millionaire. This could be a connection to the world of how human beings want to become better and improve themselves. Text to world focuses a lot on the overall message of the text. So you can make connections with basically any topic. Let's take a look at TikTok, for example. Connect with TikTok because it helps me express myself, dance and sing and connect with others. How does TikTok compare to other social medias? How is it different or the same to Instagram or Facebook? And then how does TikTok play a role in connecting people around the world? These are just some examples. Let's take a look at an actual text.
The Three Little Pigs.
I can make a text-to-self connection because the story of the Three Little Pigs talks about the planning stage of working very hard on something you would like to last, to endure. I can make a text-to-text connection as well with the story Goldilocks and the Three Bears. Goldilocks finds a just right meal in the Three Bears' house. I can compare it to the Three Little Pigs because one of the pigs in the story made a just right house that prevented the wolf from breaking in compared to the other two little pigs' houses. We also make a text-to-world connection based on the story of Three Little Pigs. Now, the text-to-world connection is the overall message of the story. It ties very closely to the theme of the story, which we will talk about in another lesson. So the message of the story could be that hard work pays off, because placing the bricks for that third little pigs took a lot of time and took a lot of work, but it paid off at the end when the pigs faced danger. So I can compare something that's happening around the world or a current event that I can think of that relates to the planning and the hard work and how it pays off in the end. For example, during this time, we have the virus called COVID-19. We can compare it to the three little pigs. It can be three ways we can respond to this virus. We can isolate ourselves and stay home, or we can go out and protect ourselves with masks and gloves, or we can just not worry about it, go out and go about our lives and not worry about getting infected or infecting others. This is a text-to-world example that we can compare to the three little pigs. Three different ways to respond to a virus. Which one of these three ways is the most preventative method? Which one would work best in this situation? So the Three Little Pigs is just a quick classic example of a text that we are very familiar with and is very popular. When it comes to the message of a text or the theme, we think about fables. Fables are quick, short stories that use personification, where the animals have human characteristics. They speak and they think and they behave like humans to demonstrate a lesson that humanity can learn from. Let's take a look at Lion and the Mouse. Let's make connections with the lion and the mouse by connecting it to ourselves, to another text, or to something that's happening in the world. I leave you with this short fable that you can read. Try to make connections again. This is about our personal experience and the way we can relate to a text. So there is no correct or wrong answer. And put these skills into practice. Reflect on these three connections that you can make with any text that you encounter. So now that you learned about those three categories of connections that we can make with the text, I will leave you with the fable, The Lion and the Mouse. And as you read, make those connections. Do you agree or disagree with the characters? How is the story similar to another one that you may have read? And how have you been in a situation like the lion or the mouse? How do people react to those in need? Ask yourself these questions as you make these connections. Continue to practice this skill in your everyday life and put it to work when you're reading something, whether online or in a magazine or newspaper or even a video blog or podcast. Make connections with your surroundings and expand your thinking. Stay tuned for more literacy strategies that you can practice in the comfort of your own home. Until next time.